Welcome into Whiteside Sports, everybody. Randy Fraley alongside Seth.
Whoop.
Captain, I can't come up with a nickname.
Oh, it's fine.
Lobcock. Do you know what this is?
Wednesday?
This is episode 100.
Oh, man.
Hey, thanks for following along with the content.
Sorry. I say the content. What? Man.
100th
man
episode of Whiteside Sports. Nobody's got arrested.
No, nobody's gotten
canceled.
Canceled. Yeah, I
mean, should have
probably by now. We should have been canceled. But congratulations,
100 episodes.
Congratulations, sir. 100 episodes.
Got a text from my brother today.
Yeah,
going
happy 100th episode.
Yeah, that's
nice,
what. Yeah,
nice.
Yeah,
nice.
Yeah, I said, yeah, we're recording it tonight.
Yeah, so, 100 episodes.
100. Who'd have thought we'd ever done that?
I don't know. I'm sure these guys didn't.
I didn't think we'd make it to 10. Like, all right. We make $6 million yet? No. Fuck it.
Fuck it.
Not worth it.
I'm sure our fans didn't think we'd make it to 100. They're probably just like, why do we still listen to this?
Hey, man, it's been through quarantine and everything.
We've made it through no sports. We've made it through sports. Oh, man.
Made it through cancellation of sports. No fans.
We are... You know, I think we're the standard now of, you know, small-time football podcasts.
Yeah. Yeah.
Yeah.
We're the standard. Everybody looks
episodes.
Up to us. 100
yeah.
episodes.
Yep.
Fucking TV, we'd be in syndication.
Yeah, we would
if
be.
If TV existed.
Yeah, and it does not.
It doesn't.
Yeah, well, that's awesome, man. 100 episodes. That's cool as shit.
Yeah, you start thinking about that of like, man, how long have we been doing this? Well, at least 100 fucking times.
Yeah. That's cool, though. I knew we were getting close.
Yeah.
Because it's been like 2 years.
Yeah, and so, and it would have been we missed a couple episodes here in the last 2 months, so it would have been,
a couple weeks ago or whatever. But
yeah. But yeah. We're here. We cracked triple digits.
We made it. That's awesome. That's awesome. I feel accomplished, and I know we haven't done shit. Like, we could get no feedback or payment for this, but it's just awesome.
It's
that
fun.
One, it's fun.
It's two guys that get to hang out and talk shit.
Pretty much.
You know, let other people listen to. We don't let you listen to what goes on before because it's normally a little too harsh.
Too much for the mic. So.
Too much.
Yeah.
Too much for the airwaves.
Yeah.
But, here's to, at least one more.
Hopefully, one more. This is for 100 right here. Well, that's awesome. So, we talked before we went on about some people naming their starting quarterbacks and stuff, and obviously we know that Andy Dalton is going to be them. And
right.
I heard where Joe Burrow is going to be making his preseason debut. Don't know why. Get him more hurt against for that offensive line.
I want to drop him back 15 times.
Yeah.
Run him 20 plays, have 18 passes.
Yeah. Don't know why that is, but and you said you thought you heard that they named Trevor Lawrence the starter?
I thought they did. Thought I've seen that on my
a double check
Twitter.
It. Where's old Adam Schefney at? Let's see.
It would only make sense that they did.
Yeah, I mean, like I told you, we were talking earlier, I watched that game, and he didn't look good.
No.
Yep, they named him. Trevor Lawrence is the starter.
Which, that's the only way it was going to go.
It's not the fact that they named him the starter. It's the fact that they made a big deal about the competition.
Yeah.
When he was
lost the competition.
Yeah. He was always going to be the starter. Yeah. There was no doubt in anybody's mind that Trevor Lawrence wasn't the starter. But you name it after the performance that he did on Monday, and it was not good.
Yeah.
He may be another Joe Burrow where he may just get his head taken off this year. Because his offensive line sucks.
Yeah.
I mean, the Saints were just eating him up. There wasn't a whole lot of run game stuff. I mean, I hope he does well. It's not like I'm rooting against the kid. But
well, they lost their running back, so.
Yeah. Well, I mean, they have the one that went for like 1,200 yards last year, so.
Yeah, but he lost his safety net in ETN.
Yeah.
For the season.
Yeah, with Liz Frank or whatever.
Yep.
Yeah, I mean, I like I said, and then when Gardner Minshew came in, Lawrence was the starter, no doubt. Minshew comes in against the Saints, probably 2s and 3s, and the offense just looked faster. I'm not saying it was better.
Yeah.
I mean, I knew he threw a pick and Lawrence didn't, but the offense just looked faster. Now, again, it's going to get better because he's just going to get the more reps and he's going to see it more and this and that. But yeah, there's a lot. I think there's a lot more for the Jaguars to improve on than just everybody focusing on the quarterback play.
Well, and I think, too, of I get a little tired. And this just isn't an Urban Meyer thing. This is every year. Well, we're going to, you know, it's going to be a quarterback competition. You know, it's like, it's not because you drafted that guy first.
Yeah. Yeah, it's not.
It's not. Uh-huh. Let's not. I mean, it hadn't happened and it wasn't even a competition. When the Bengals drafted Palmer.
Yeah.
Back in what, 2003 or whatever.
Something like that. Yeah.
He didn't play at all the first year. And that was the, hey, you're going to sit this year. We got John Kitna. You're going to watch him stick in his hip pocket, learn how to play.
Yep.
That's the last time that's ever happened.
They don't. No, that doesn't happen anymore. No. I mean, look at everybody else from then on. Look at the number one quarterbacks taken overall. They just went and played.
Yeah.
So you don't, with the win now mentality of the NFL, he's going to play.
Yeah.
It's, you just got to help him out and do whatever you can. Now, I thought Daryl Bevel is their offensive coordinator. I don't like that.
He sounds like somebody's
hire.
Done something that bad.
Yeah.
Like his name, Daryl Bevel. Like,
he's a criminal.
Yeah. I mean, it's like
a little bit. I just don't like his offensive scheme. Like, it didn't work in Seattle. It didn't work. I think he was with a couple other people. Like, it's got to change. And I know they hired him because they like the way he's a run first kind of guy and this and that. And they want to get the young quarterback a run game. I'm like, it's just not, it's not a, it just doesn't look good. It's not, it's slow. It's takes a while for things to develop. It's not, you know, you look at, obviously not everybody's Kyle Shanahan with his run schemes, but that shit happens fast. They're fast plays. There's not a whole lot of stretch. I mean, it's.
Yeah, I think that's the, when you have a youngster.
Nice.
Like the Kyle Shanahan stuff is where you need to look at of like spreading the field out. Let's make this quick because this kid's not ready for NFL shit.
Yeah, exactly.
We got to bring him along.
Mm-hmm.
Unlike Cincinnati of like, hey, let's just keep dropping him back.
Throwing.
And chucking
getting
it.
Getting him killed.
You know, you gotta have that quick hit stuff. Realize that, hey, we're not a good team.
Yep.
We got to get some wins, but we got to also not get him murdered.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I think, you know, you look at their division. I think they can count two wins versus the Texans. I don't know. You know what I mean? But you open up, I'm pretty sure they open up in Denver. You know, talk about my team, but it's a pretty veteran defense that he's going against. It's a veteran defensive coordinator he's going against. He may struggle heavily in that first game. I mean, you got two pass rushers on the edge. Von Miller's probably a Hall of Famer. Bradley Chubb is an up-and-coming outside linebacker pass rush. I mean, they're going to get after him, and I think he's going to struggle that first week.
Yeah, and that's one of those things, too, of like, hey, realize Peyton Manning's rookie year, he threw 27 interceptions.
Yeah. It's a record.
That's the one thing, too, of like these, hey, they played him in the first round. What do you do this year? Well, he threw 15 touchdowns and 8 interceptions.
Yeah.
He's a piece of shit.
Yeah.
It's like,
no.
Well, Peyton Manning threw 27 interceptions.
And 13 touchdowns.
Mm-hmm. So, let's fucking calm down. Guy's a fucking piece of shit.
Yeah.
We shouldn't. He's a bust. It's like, it's been 4 games.
Yeah. Let's calm down.
That was one I seen on the Twids the other day. Was talking about how big a bust Joe Burrow is. Of like, he played 6 fucking games before he had his leg ripped off.
Yeah.
And they should have won 5 of them, and he played pretty fucking well. How is he a bust?
Yeah. And if your field goal kicker was anything, you wouldn't have had a tie.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Like, he's just the biggest bust that's been so far. Like,
yeah.
What is wrong with you people?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't see it.
People suck.
Yeah, and then, you know, going in with the whole quarterback thing, the Broncos picked Teddy Bridgewater, which, again, why wasn't it already made?
Hey, we traded for a guy that's a starting quarterback in the league to compete with a guy that's not any good.
Yeah.
It's going to be a competition.
Yeah.
Fuck off. Pick your goddamn quarterback, go into camp, and practice like a team.
Yeah.
Drew, you're the backup.
Yeah.
Do backup shit.
Yeah. I just don't know why it took so fucking long.
Racist. It has to be. This day and age, 2021, it's the only answer.
But I'm glad they named him. I mean, you know, it's nice. Nice to see. Nice to see we have a starting quarterback.
because you guys are defensive driven. Mm-hmm. You know, you've got some weapons.
Yeah.
Teddy's not. Is he going to win you a shit ton of games?
No. No. But he's not going to.
He's
going to
march
any.
You down the field, but he ain't going to chuck it into the defensive meeting room.
Yeah, he's not going to
like Drew. I'll just fuck throw it up.
Yeah.
Well, hey, man.
Let's see who can come down and get it.
That ain't the way the NFL works.
No. I like it. I was okay with the trade. I mean, we literally gave up nothing to get him. Contract's not terrible. And he's a better quarterback. He takes care of the football.
And you're in a spot that if Rodgers comes available.
Yep. He's ours. I mean,
bye, Teddy.
Yeah.
I mean, that's just the way it is.
Yeah. I mean, it's this the way it's probably going to end up being if he does become available. I mean, I think everybody can kind of see that happening.
That'd be the thing if Denver just became to the place of like, hey, are you a Hall of Fame quarterback whose team's shitting on you? Come here and win a Super Bowl.
That's
like
what we do.
Like in 20 years from now, if they had like four Super Bowls and they were all the same.
Yeah.
Like, well.
Peyton won as one. Aaron Rodgers won as one. You know, somebody else. Yeah. Yeah. I'm interested. I'm excited for the NFL season. I think that you're going to, you know, we have a lot of returning teams. There wasn't a whole lot of.
Right.
You know what I mean? You didn't see a whole lot of turnaround. The Buccaneers kept every one of their players. The Chiefs
their whole coaching staff and all 22 starters
are back,
which is
unheard of.
How do you do that?
I mean, it's the only team I've ever seen give their defensive coordinator a raise so he stays a coordinator.
Yeah.
That's the only, I mean, you never see that.
Yeah.
You never see that. Which is cool as shit, because obviously, you know, Arians wants to keep everybody together.
Right.
I mean, Arians kind of gave Todd Bowles the head coaching job, his first one. I mean, his defense with Arians got him a head coaching job. The defensive performance in the Super Bowl probably should have gotten him a head coaching job. But they're like, no, we're just going to give you a little bit more money to stay
here.
That's
one of those things, too, if you're Bruce going in there. I mean, like, hey, Todd. Well, I guess in the Bruce Arians thing, hey, man. You fucking want another couple hundred thousand fucking dollars to stay here and fucking, or you want to go fucking coach at another fucking place that just won one fucking game and you're going to be fired in three fucking years.
Yeah. No, that's probably exactly how that went.
Win another Super Bowl or go get fired in 3 years. Cause
that's what it is.
You know, hey, you're a super coordinator.
Mm-hmm.
You're getting a shit job. You're going to go coach Jacksonville.
Yeah, exactly.
I mean, Urban Meyer he's out of coaching. He's a college guy. First job in the NFL. And the owners basically said, hey, anything you want, you can have.
Yeah.
All right, well, tear all your shit down and we're all building new stuff.
Mm-hmm.
Okay?
Okay. Yeah.
Anybody else outside of Urban Meyer? Todd Bowles? Ain't nobody doing that shit.
Nope. Yeah, but it's cool. Like I was saying, I mean, it's you didn't have a lot of turnaround. There wasn't a whole lot of huge free agent signings. You know what I mean? Like, right. So I think that you're going to have some good competition. Divisions are going to be tough. I think all around divisions should be tough.
Yeah.
Obviously you have like, you know, the NFC East where it's tough, but it's just tough because they suck.
They're still in the NFL, but it's like, well, who's doing what?
Mm-hmm.
I'll tell you what, I mean, the AFC North is a fucking murderer's
fucking
row.
Juggernaut, man.
And obviously I'm a Bengals fan, which is tough.
Yeah.
But you go back into the AFC, the East.
Mm-hmm.
Of like,
it's tough, too.
Hey, man, maybe this kid for the Jets can be okay. He seems like he's okay.
Yeah.
Like, you know, Patriots coming back. Mm-hmm. Bills are good.
Yeah, yeah.
Dolphins are, hey, I mean,
Dolphins are probably the most well-coached team.
Yeah.
They just don't have a lot of the guys.
They don't have a quarterback. Yeah. And they don't, I mean.
We don't know what Tua is.
Nope. But it's like, it's all getting to that of like, hey, man, if you win your division, you fucking done something.
I mean, then you go into it. Obviously, the AFC South, you have really two top-notch teams there.
Right.
If, you know, last year, if fucking Billy O dipshit doesn't make that stupid fucking trade, you have three good teams in that division. Yeah. One trade really just kind of pushed them out of the way. And then the NFC West is still a tough one. I mean, the Chargers are up and coming. The Broncos are okay. The Chiefs are the fucking Chiefs. And then the Raiders kind of just do Raiders shit. You know, you never know what the hell you're going to get with
them.
Get
looked into by the IRS for how they sold tickets or
exactly,
something. I mean,
something.
It's like, what the fuck? Everybody's quitting.
Yeah, you just never fucking know what the hell they do.
I'll tell you what, man. I told Mark he didn't have to pay them taxes, man. He can keep that money. The only owner that's not a billionaire.
Yeah. Mark Davis.
Which is just
weird.
That is, and I'd heard this bantered about on another show of like, at what point in time does he go into the barber and go, yeah, fuck it, do that. Yeah. And I'll keep it forever. I think it was AJ Hawk talking about, because he knew guys that played there, and they said they loved Mark. Like, uh-huh. He's
seems like a good dude.
He was a, hey, my dad owns a team and goes out and does, you know, weird rich kid shit.
Yeah.
It was like he said, like, every day you go to lunch at P.F. Chang's. And it makes sense. Yes. Like, you look at him and go,
yeah,
that's exactly what he does.
Yeah, no, that makes total
wearing
sense.
All white.
Yep.
For some reason.
And a gold chain, probably.
A gold chain and a Chucky haircut.
Yep.
Him walking around the Vegas Strip.
Yes. Cock out, ready to go.
Hey, baby.
Yeah, I'm Mark
Davis.
You
seen a crisp $100 bill? I don't have one.
Yeah, can't afford it. That's my stadium over there, though. I have to live in that.
Which they said that they had SummerSlam there. Obviously, I was listening to McAfee. This is like halfway through it, like their system went down. They couldn't sell hot dogs or anything. Like, yeah, maybe get that shit together.
Taken care of before the season starts. But, you know, and then you look on the other side of the NFL, obviously the NFC East, the NFC North, you have, that one's such a weird division too, because you never, like, they play fucking hard.
Yeah.
Like the Vikings, they're a hard-nosed team. They end up not winning games.
When Zimmer's about to fucking have a heart attack.
Yeah, he's got to die some point in time. I mean, he's got to go back.
Like, he's just like, can we fucking get this shit taken care of so we can fuck practice?
Yeah. No shit.
Like, you can just see him. I love, he might have been, I haven't seen the last couple episodes of Hard Knocks. I keep hearing they're not great.
They're okay. They're just not.
They're not what you want to see.
Yeah, they're just nothing exciting.
But when the Bengals were on the 1 year, was the last year Zimmer was their defense coordinator. He was there of like, he is just awesome.
Yeah, just a fiery guy.
I mean, just, and then you see that of like what's going on in their situations going, like he's straight up ready to murder somebody.
Yeah.
Of like, Zimmer's going to have to step down as head coach because he killed his quarterback.
Yeah, shit. You don't know what you're going to get out of the Lions. You just don't.
Nothing.
No, I mean, you're going to get somebody. It seems like they're going to compete.
Yeah.
If you listen to their coach, I mean, some teams may be missing kneecaps, but,
cut his long snapper on his 40th birthday. And he goes, I'm an asshole.
Yeah. And then the Bears. What the fuck are the Bears?
But nothing.
They were a playoff fucking team last year.
Probably will be again. They make the, like, well, because they start every season 6-0.
Yeah.
And then don't win. You know, they're like the Steelers start out 11-0, and it's like, hey, can we make it?
Yeah.
But that's the Bears every year. Every single year, in their first five games, are either 5-0 or they're 4-1.
Yeah. Then they don't know how to finish a season.
Yeah. Well, that's another one, because, you know, Justin Fields has to come out and say, it's incredibly disrespectful for you guys to keep booing Andy Dalton every time he gets on. I mean.
Yeah, exactly.
Let's not. Are you a fan of the fucking team or not?
The backup quarterback has to come out and say that.
Please don't do that.
Please don't boo him. He's starting. Please don't boo him.
Andy Dalton might be the greatest quarterback you've ever fucking had there.
He might be. 100% might
be. Obviously, Justin hadn't played yet.
Yeah.
But he's for sure won more games than anybody that you've had.
And the people shit on Andy Dalton because he just couldn't win a fucking playoff game. Do you know how many fucking quarterbacks could not win a playoff game?
Most of them.
Most of them. Peyton Manning got his ass beat year after year by Tom Brady in the playoffs.
Yeah.
Nobody wants to talk about that, though.
Well, yeah, and that's the other one of, like, if he doesn't get one in Denver, what are we going to say about Peyton Manning? One fucking Super Bowl?
Yeah.
Nobody says that. Like, they'll say that shit about Roger. He's only got one.
Yeah.
Peyton Manning only had fucking one. He still technically only does have one because he didn't fucking win it for him.
You know, if in like 2000, when the Steelers won theirs, Cowers last year.
Yeah.
If Big Ben doesn't trip up that guy who recovers that fumble, the Colts are going to the Super Bowl.
Yeah.
They fumbled it on the one. The guy picks it up and Ben sticks his hand out there and the guy trips over his hand and falls. I mean, that's a touch. That's you win. You win the game there. it's shit like that. Where, but it's Peyton Manning, so yeah. He's okay because it's Peyton Manning.
Yeah,
yeah.
One, you know, and the one that he won in Indianapolis, they beat the Bears down in Miami, and the fucking Rex Grossman
was your quarterback.
Like somehow it was such a weird scenario of how they made it to the Super Bowl. It's like, well, they can't. Rex Grossman can't win a Super Bowl.
No, they should have. The Saints should have beat him in the NFC Championship game.
Of like, what?
Yeah.
How did the Bears make it to this? Like, and most people forget that they were there.
Mm-hmm.
I'm like,
yeah.
You made it to another one with a shitty offense.
Super Bowls, and then, you know, I just used Peyton Manning because he just got into the Hall of Fame. Peyton Manning, when they lost to the Saints, had a terrible game.
Yeah.
The game where he was with Denver with the Seahawks. He had a terrible game.
Horrible.
Anybody watched that game? It was awful. So, he's off on Andy Dalton. He hasn't done anything wrong.
No.
He's a good dude. He shuts up. Doesn't say anything wrong. He's not he doesn't draw attention to himself.
He had double-digit wins like 4 years in a row in Cincinnati.
With subpar team. Yeah, subpar team.
He might be the greatest quarterback of all time.
In the Bears?
No, just in football.
Oh.
Double-digit wins like 4 years in a row for the Bengals? Get the fuck out of here,
right,
man.
All time. Best
Tom
all time.
Brady, piece of shit. Yeah. Ooh, 7 Super Bowls. Hey, go try winning Cincinnati, pal.
There's no indoor facility.
The bad thing is the playoff game they should have won wasn't even him. That was A.J. McCarron.
Yeah, I know it. But yeah, I don't know what the hell is up with them. It's just letting him fucking go play football. He might win some games. Who knows?
Probably will.
Who knows? Yeah, and then you go into the West, which is they may have fucking 4 teams in the playoffs.
Yeah, you don't. That's the one like you can't even. Who's going to win that?
Yeah,
I assume the Rams, but yeah. I don't know. All I know is the Cardinals spent a shit ton of money.
Yeah,
and they'll be like five. Well, they can't be 500.
Yeah,
they won't sniff the playoffs.
Mm-hmm.
Like they'll be like, or let's say they won't sniff a division title because Kyler Murray's going to do stupid shit.
Yeah.
Not sold on him.
Mm-hmm. I'm not either. Not either. I mean, he's a manageable quarterback, but he's not winning you a Super Bowl.
Right.
He's a manageable quarterback. I mean, you can get wins with him, but you're not getting to the playoffs with him.
I mean, hey, you got all kinds of fucking weapons around you.
Yeah.
Like, you can't have, in the division you're playing in, you can't have that game that you had last year. It's like, hey, for some reason this week, Kyler Murray went 12 for 36 for 107 yards.
Yeah.
Can't do it.
No, again, I mean, and then the same team 3 weeks before, you were like, you know, 21 to 25, 250 yards, 3 touchdowns. Like,
yeah.
You can't have that.
Can't do that.
No. And then, obviously, the Seahawks, the Niners, and the fucking Rams. The fucking Rams are going to be good.
Yeah.
The Rams are going to be really good. You have Matthew Stafford in an offense to where it's all play action.
Yep.
To where you're getting him, he's throwing deep routes, he's throwing it to good receivers. You just traded for Sony Michel, so now your run game's back.
Gave up your only 2 draft picks I think you have for the next 10 years.
Probably.
Well, Bill, these are our last 2, so all we got.
So, you know, your run game's back now, and they had a solid run game last year.
I don't why is Belichick trading Michel?
It's because I think when he got hurt last year, they just signed 2 other guys, and he likes him better.
All right.
I don't know, though. I mean,
it's just a weird thing. I'm like, all
somebody
right.
offered him some good picks for him. So he's like, okay,
good
yeah.
Good picks, what he thinks. He's terrible at drafting players. So,
well, plus, like, Michel had just been on, like, the third team stuff in preseason. Even when the ones were out there, he wasn't playing with them. He was, like, their third down back.
Yeah.
I don't know why. He's had a good rookie year. Last year, he got hurt. Not his fault.
We didn't have a good year. It's because you don't give him the ball, Bill.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And then obviously the South. Obviously, the Bucs are going to be fucking good. We don't know about the Saints. Obviously, they haven't
named their quarterback yet, have they?
No, and Jameis Winston played really, really good Monday night.
He looked like an NFL quarterback.
Yeah. He looked like Sean Payton knows how to fucking coach football.
You know what Taysom Hill looks like? A guy that plays a bunch of positions.
That's exactly what he looks like. And I think this might have been the only thing I've ever agreed with Booger McFarland on. He goes, do you want Jameis Winston and Taysom Hill, or do you want Jason Winston or Taysom Hill? And I'm like, yeah, that's a really, really good point.
Yeah.
Do you want Taysom Hill to run all the cool shit that he runs? 100%. That means Jameis Winston has to be your starting quarterback.
Right.
Because if Taysom Hill's the starter, you don't have all that whole side of the playbook's gone.
From the way it sounds, as if Taysom Hill's not the starting quarterback, he's trying to force himself out.
Really?
Like, hey, man. You're just going to go to another team and do Taysom Hill shit, right?
Yeah. Because
you're not a quarterback.
Yeah, and the only other team that's going to be good enough to make him that, the Rams or New England.
Yeah. It's either you can make your $17 million that we fucking...
Yeah.
With your voidable contract.
Yeah.
Or...
You go make five somewhere else and you just do special team shit.
Yeah, you get vet men.
Yeah.
Get, hey, you're a special teams player.
Mm-hmm.
We don't need a goofy shit guy.
Yeah, exactly. I don't know, man. I don't know why it's a competition. Winston's just... He's a quarterback.
Yeah. Well, that's one. I know he threw 30 interceptions. There's four guys in the history of the NFL threw 5,000 yards. He's fucking one of them.
Yep. Yeah. So he's got potential, man.
I mean,
just quit giving the ball to the other team.
And that was when he was blind.
Yeah. Now he can see.
Now he can see.
Now he can see. Yeah. It's and then, you know, who else is in there? The Falcons have a new coach. You don't know what the fuck they're going to get with a little noodle arm. They lost Julio Jones, so you don't fucking know
Ridley
there.
Ridley will play half the games.
That's just what he does.
He'll play well in half the games. The other half of the games that he won't play well in is when I put him on my team. Say, hey, they're playing a shitty defense. He should have a good game.
Nope.
Catch for negative 2 yards.
Yeah.
And then he came out with a pulled cock.
That sucks. I hate when I get my cock pulled.
Yeah.
Eh, tug. Maybe not.
Well, they tug on it. You know?
Yeah.
I don't know what they're
feel
doing.
Good. And then who knows what the Panthers are? They're such a quiet team. Like, you make a big trade for Sam Darnold. And then you hear nothing about them.
The only thing you hear about them is like, hey, still trying to get Deshaun Watson.
Yeah, exactly.
They make a trade for Sam Darnold, and the only information you hear out of Carolina is, hey, we're still looking for a quarterback.
Yeah. So I don't know what the hell they're going to do. Who the hell else is in that division? Oh, I talked about everybody. Oh, good.
Did we?
Yeah, Saints, Bucks, Falcons, and Panthers.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, Bucks.
Yeah, it's who knows, but the new playoff system, now you have teams that are like, hey, we may not be the best, but we don't have to be the best. We just have to be better.
Extra wild
we just
card.
Have to be better than those other teams. You know, I mean, it's like for the just like the NFC West, I mean, they possibly could have fucking all four teams in.
Yeah.
I mean, you know, really on that side, I mean,
yeah.
The Cardinals have to probably win 9 games.
Well, it's like that. I mean, there's multiple of it. Like last year, 3 of the 4 in the AFC North made it to the playoffs.
Mm-hmm.
Probably going to happen again this year.
Probably.
But there's multiple divisions that you could see that happening.
Mm-hmm.
Of like, well, this one could, and that one, you know.
I think, to me, the AFC has more of a, like, I think the Bucks are the best team.
Yeah.
Than the Chiefs.
Yeah.
But I think overall the AFC just has way more fucking contenders.
It's a motherfucker.
Than the I mean, it's just ridiculous. We just named 3 teams out of the North, 3 teams out of the East. You got 2 teams in the South, and between 1 and 3 teams in the West.
Yeah. Well, and that's the thing too. Of like in the AFC, like the AFC West.
Yeah.
The Raiders are going to win between 8 to 10 games.
Yeah.
I don't think they're going to get to 10, but 8 or 9 wins, which is a good season in the NFL. But you don't talk about them because the fucking Chiefs are there.
Exactly.
Chargers are going to be a good team, and they're going to win that 8 to whatever game. Mm-hmm. But you don't talk about them because fuck, Chiefs are there. Mm-hmm. And, you know, Denver, you know, it's all that. They just get shoved to the side because Chiefs are here.
Yeah.
I mean.
Yeah. I mean, the AFC's a fucking bitch, man.
Yeah.
It's tough. It's tough.
Sounds like Indianapolis is going to have their quarterback in the first wait. Look, the fact he's back to practice.
Yeah.
He's
6 weeks. 2.
He's not allowed to move.
Yeah.
For a month. Like, well it's been like 12 fucking days and he's running on the field doing cuts. So.
And the offensive lineman had the same surgery and he's been back
he's
for
back.
A week.
Yeah.
So I think you're okay. I mean, he's going to get hurt again because it's just what he does. But
yeah,
it's
but
just when.
But that's not what he does because it's not footed. Like when he gets hurt, he breaks his back.
Yeah.
Like that's the other thing. He's like, he's injury prone. But it's like, no, he tore his knee up and then he broke his fucking back.
Yeah. He's injury prone.
So it's not, I mean.
Yeah. And he tore his knee up.
He can't act like he's fragile.
Yeah. And he tore his knee up on just a freak play. Like a guy put his helmet on his knee. How many people do you know get a knee to the helmet all the time and it's just sore? Like he tore his whole fucking knee. With a helmet to the leg.
Yeah.
It wasn't a stick in the ground. It wasn't a plant.
And then at the end of the day, it was his fault.
Mm-hmm.
Because he should have slid.
Yeah, exactly. Not dive.
And like 2 plays earlier, he faked like he was going to slide, and then he picked up 5 more yards, which I assume to a defense says, we're going to murder that motherfucker.
Fucker next time,
Hey, if you're going to go down, go down.
Yep.
But don't fake it.
We'll take the 15. It's fine. We're going to hit you.
You're getting it, motherfucker.
But yeah, it's going to be a good year in the NFL. I know we say that probably every year, but the NFL is just so awesome.
Everybody's so good. Like, I still love that. Like, people, Twittersphere, like, they just shit on, like, they'll shit on the Jaguars. Like, mm-hmm. You know, those are all NFL players.
Yeah.
And you realize the other team's just really fucking good. Like, these guys are better than everybody.
Mm-hmm.
And it's, you know, that talk that was, I think Alabama can get them.
No.
Out that they would score 100 on Alabama, mm-hmm. and Alabama might score a couple field goals.
Mm hmm.
Because it's the fucking NFL.
It's just different, guys, man. You're going to play a base defense all game? Yeah, they're going to pick that apart.
They're going to play their base. The Jaguars go and play their base fucking nickel.
Yeah.
Which is basically base defense in the NFL mm-hmm. now. And it's crazier than anything anybody's ever seen in college exactly. football. And that's their basic shit.
Yep. Yeah.
It's just different level.
Different level.
Men's league. JV.
Yeah.
That's we're by the time anybody hears this or whatever, we're 1 week away from college football.
Yeah. Yeah, we are.
Which I think there's some this weekend, but nobody cares.
Yeah. Probably like what? They open up with like the MAC or
it's FCS some bullshit. Or something. They call it week zero.
Yeah.
I'm like, shut up. Fuck yourself.
Yeah.
Nobody cares.
A week from tomorrow is the Ohio State opens up with Minnesota.
Yeah. Gonna roll them boats in there. Yeah.
The Minnesota with the Gophers up north there.
Yeah, we got them Gophers, you know?
Yeah, the Gophers with their buck teeth.
Like that girl from Minnesota. Oh, crap.
Yeah.
That's one of my...
Oh, crap. Oh, crap.
Oh, crap. Oh, God. Oh, crap.
Oh, crap.
Row them boats.
Who wants tacos? warm tortilla.
Minnesota people.
That northern accent just cracks me up. It's so weird.
Well, when I was up in Fargo playing in that tournament, the lady that we're friends with... we were talking about the movie Fargo.
Yeah.
She's like, that's just not our accent. I'm like, mm-hmm. it fucking is.
Yeah.
So that's a Minnesota accent. It's like, like you sound
just like that.
Like that was Francis.
Yeah.
Like you guys sound identical to each other.
Mm-hmm.
It's just not ours.
Yeah.
Yeah, it is.
It's you. It's hey there, fucking there. It's Canada. It's Canada. Yeah. It's Canada. Oh man, it's just that whole like I didn't really. This was before I took a fishing trip up in Canada a few years ago, but before I did that, you hear about it, but you never really you never actually hear it. Sometimes, right. But we were at a family reunion, and one of relations or whatever, her husband was from Wisconsin, straight up Wisconsin, you know, like North Wisconsin, like not even like any towns you've probably ever fucking heard of. It's not Green Bay, and that's the only was. Town in Wisconsin that I really know about.
Madison, maybe.
Nah, probably not. but
Milwaukee.
All of his, that one out there. It's fine. All of his, like, O's were, you know, the way that they say it. I'm like, why does he fucking keep saying weird shit? And finally I asked, and I'm like, you say your O's weird? And he goes, well, yeah, that's just my accent. And I'm like, talking about? He's like, you say shit weird too. And I'm like, I don't have an accent.
No.
He's like, yes, you do. I was like, no, I don't. Like, I don't fucking tell me
we
what I
have. We actually live in an area that is considered the no accent mm-hmm. area. That's how bland we are here in the...
in Ohio.
In Ohio.
We have nothing.
But, I was at a bar in Wisconsin. It's kind of like a... pretty cool, actually. It was like an outdoor, you know, sitting outside mm-hmm. and they had like big lights and everything and probably like 6 beach volleyball courts.
Oh, okay. Yeah,
pretty fucking cool. Awesome. And it was just like off the interstate.
Yeah.
Not really in a city. Uh-huh. I mean, and just sitting there and people were out like they had like a league going on.
Oh,
and like
okay.
they're getting
yeah.
in, you know, it was like a mixed league. Men and women, I mean.
Yeah, that's good. Thanks for clarifying. Thanks for clarifying that. Appreciate that.
I've seen the look on your face. I'm like, yeah, better throw that in there. But it was like, you know, they were taking it was very serious.
Yeah.
And to hear them yelling and stuff with that,
yeah,
with that accent, it was just like, this is fucking comical.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, because like,
oh,
hey, you get that ball there.
Yeah, spike it. Oh, good bump.
Good bump. You gonna set up that better? You fucking moron.
Yeah. Hey, buddy.
No, the hey, buddy, that's Canada.
That's Canada, yeah.
Hey there.
Hey there. Hey there. Oh, there.
It's always that. Hey there.
Hey there, buddy. Yeah, good stuff.
Northern
Northern
people.
Accents. Do you want to go ahead and pick
that's
our...
That's always one thing, too, of like, end up talking about that. Then I end up like, yeah, I was just at a bar randomly in fucking Wisconsin one time.
Get it. Get just
because who's that?
Yeah. Do you want to go ahead and pick our division winners for this NFL season?
Fucking A, there's nothing I'd rather do at this moment in time.
All right. Okay, let's...
Hey.
What?
By episode 200, can we get some fucking air conditioning in here?
Yeah, I got you heat, you know, last winter.
Yeah,
so
but
I
you
guess...
turn it on 3 minutes before I get here.
That's because I get home 3 minutes before you get here. And you're
hey,
not
I
even...
hey, I got the heat going on. Well, it's still 30.
It's all right. But yeah, I'll try.
I'd go for that.
Yeah, I
get right now. Right it now. Is hot as fuck in Ohio right
oh
now.
Oh my God, it's awful. All right.
Sticky. It's good. It's good high school football weather.
No shit.
Hey, can we run, Ruya? Just get the fuck out of here.
That's my goal, man. Put fucking 30 on. Let's get that running clock in the second half.
Oh, is that how that goes still?
Yeah. It's kind of nice. Like, that's my goal. Like, every first half, I'm like, let's get up by 30. Let's just get this fuck out of here. All right, who do you want to start with? You can start with the AFC or the NFC?
You call it, man. You call it, and I'll tell you who wins it.
All right.
And obviously, I'll be correct.
Let's go AFC North. Who wins it?
Cleveland?
You said that with a question mark. Are you going with Cleveland?
Cleveland? Because I can't believe I'm saying it, but I think they do.
All righty.
Are you going to pick?
I am going to pick. I am going with... I can't believe I'm doing this, but I'm going with the Ravens.
I knew you were going to go there.
I don't know what...
Have they figured out Lamar Jackson yet?
He says no.
So his mom's not doing a good job for him?
Yeah.
He's not in there.
Nope.
Negotiating well?
Nope. Yeah, I don't know. But I'm going Ravens. I don't know what it is. I hate the other hardball, but I love this hardball.
Yeah.
I mean, he's... I think I said hardball there. Harball.
Well, I'm a big fan of Keanu Reeves' movie.
Yeah, it's a great movie. But... I
sad as fuck though.
It is. God damn, G baby gets shot at the end.
Yeah. Fucking cucumbas though.
God, those cucumbas.
Team cucumba.
I don't know what it is, but I just like the Ravens.
I think a little bit with that Harbaugh, it's because he was always a special teams guy.
Yeah.
And he doesn't have this.
Yeah, this ego to him that
ego
I know
that I'm
everything.
I was quarterback at Michigan. I jerk off in front of people. Do you?
Yeah, I don't. I understand.
Do you think that, like, all the shit that Louis C.K. did, you know, the jerking off in front of other people. Like, I tie that to the other Harbaugh.
Yeah.
Of like, I feel like that's something you would do.
Yeah.
Hey, you mind if I jerk off in this ficus? I know I'm spending the night get your son to try to come here, and he's a fucking punter.
That's so
where
weird.
Everybody else just calls Australia and says, hey, can you just ship one of those fucking guys over here? I don't care.
Yeah,
AFC North. I don't know. Nobody runs away with it because I. The thing is, I feel like the Bengals are gonna ruin one of their seasons. As far as I think three teams are making the playoffs. So as far as winning the actual division,
yeah.
So it's like if the Ravens don't win the division, it's because somehow the Bengals beat them.
Yeah, some weird...
It's going to be...
The bad thing is, like, they all fucking split.
Yeah.
Like, the top three, it seems like they always split. And it's so fucking weird.
Yeah.
So weird.
But that's... Hey.
It's just what football is, man.
Hey, you know, it's an Ohio-based division. That pissed some fucking people off. What are you fucking talking about? Well, two of the teams in the division are from Ohio, and the third team moved from Ohio. So it's an Ohio-based fucking division.
Yeah. All righty. AFC East, who you got?
I'm gonna go with the Bills, even though I already
was typing Bills for you.
Even though I think the Patriots are gonna fucking do something.
I'm picking the Patriots.
Yeah.
You know, with the whole... I don't understand their grief with Cam right now. Like, I understand that, you know, he did what he was supposed to do. It just was a miscommunication. Like, he's not vaccinated, so he has to do, like, the...
Right.
And he did that, but they didn't explain what the miscommunication was. Like, he went to an area where it was okay for him to go. Like, he got permission to go there. Then he was still tested every day that he was away. Go ahead.
But.
Okay.
Wasn't tested by the NFL.
Gotcha. That was the miscommunication.
The 5-day thing, he missed a test. That's what it is.
Okay, I gotcha. But I mean, it's, everybody, I know it's a big deal, but they're like, oh, it opens up a window for Mac Jones. It does. But
I don't think so.
I don't think so either.
I don't know that. I think all that shit, like you, it's just people talking.
Yeah.
Cam's a quarterback. Mm-hmm. And if Mac Jones, when Mac Jones needs to play, Mac Jones will play.
Uh-huh.
This is good for Mac Jones because he gets a week of, hey, you're the starting quarterback mm-hmm. this week. Let's see what you do.
Yeah.
But yeah, the whole thing of one, that doesn't happen in New England because mm-hmm. somebody just missed the caveat
of
like, hey, yeah, I need to get this treatment or whatever. I have to go outside.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Okay. Everything's good. I'm going to get tested, tested. But then there's that little, well, you didn't get tested by the NFL here at the facility. It's like 6:30 a.m. You have to be tested at the facility.
Yeah.
So he missed a test.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Okay. That's,
and it's the it's the last preseason game. And if he started quarterback, he wouldn't play anyway. Yeah. So.
No shit. All righty. AFC South.
Oh.
You going with?
You know who I'm going with.
Colts.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's because I don't.
I'm not just doing this to go opposite. I really think the Titans are going to win it. I haven't seen anybody stop the run game yet.
Right.
Now, what the offensive coordinator left, it could change. I don't think it's going to change much.
Right.
Because it's, why wouldn't you still give the ball to Derrick Henry? But a team has not stopped that yet.
No.
And that opens up play action like crazy. And then you just got the best receiver on your team. So now even A.J. Brown was a fantastic receiver last year. One of them is going to be single covered now.
Right.
So I think that opens up a ton for them.
The only thing, nobody stops Derrick Henry. The only thing that stops Derrick Henry is the other team scoring points.
Yeah. Yep.
All their games when they got beat, you know, down the stretch last year, you know, you lose some games earlier in the year that they're still trying to figure out who your team is.
Uh-huh.
But when they got beat, it's because, hey, we got down two scores real quick. It's pretty tough in the second half. Just keep handing the fucking ball off.
Yeah.
We got to score.
Yeah.
That's how they get beat.
Mm-hmm.
I always go with the Colts just because, you know,
it's hard to root against them.
Yeah.
Yeah. No, I'm with you.
Yeah.
Yeah. And I mean, the Titans, I just think that nobody has stopped them enough for me to pick somebody else.
Yeah.
We don't know. Like, obviously, I think Wentz is a pretty good quarterback, but we don't know.
No.
He's coming off of an injury again for however many weeks he hadn't played. It's not new because he was with whatever in Philly. You just never know.
And a little bit of it's like, hey, I kind of want to see Paris Campbell stay healthy and fucking win.
Yeah.
I mean,
something.
He just has weird injuries.
Yeah.
Like, hey, you broke your hand.
Yeah.
Weird. Well, that's fucking weird, but you're a receiver, so it's kind of tough to play.
Yeah. I'm assuming we're both picking the same for the West.
Yeah, there's a pretty good chance that that's going to be what it is. Yeah. Obviously, it's the Broncos.
The Chiefs. Yeah, no, it's if
outside of the NFC North, that's the bulk of the money, you know, as far as people betting on that, whatever, because the NFC North obviously is the Packers.
Yeah.
But that AFC West has to be the same way of like nobody's picking any.
Yeah.
You know, the only reason you're putting $100 on another team is because you get fucking plus 3,000 odds on
exactly.
it. I mean,
yeah. So I'm assuming since now we can go to the NFC North where we're going to both pick the Packers.
Yeah, that's pretty.
Okay, cool.
I don't think Dan Campbell can do it. We're going to bite your kneecap.
I feel like it would just be cool as shit to play for that guy. I don't know.
Dude.
I mean, he just seems like the guy that you want to play because he's just nuts.
I don't know if you watched it with McAfee's show, but last week Bobby Carpenter was on the show.
A little bit.
When he was in Dallas, he didn't play with Dan Campbell, but Dan Campbell lived in Dallas. So I think he might have been playing in Detroit at the time or whatever.
Yeah.
But he said they went to a concert that was like out, you know, mm-hmm. it was like out in a field kind of like a country concert kind of thing. It was like Bobby Carpenter, some other, and Dan Campbell.
Mm-hmm.
He said, it's on a Saturday, and the next day is Mother's Day.
Gotcha.
Dan Campbell's married with children at the time.
Okay.
And he says, yeah, we got like a bus and everything like that, so we're gathering everybody up, and we're going. He says, we went to get Dan. He said, he's standing there, smoking a cigarette, going, Dan, hey, we got to go. He goes, I'm going to stay with the band. Like, hey, it's Mother's Day tomorrow. Like, you have a I'm wife good. And kids. Now I'm going to stay and party with the band. You guys go ahead. And that's what happened.
That's awesome.
That's your head football
coach. But
just back to like you smoking a cigarette. Going, yeah.
I'm going to stay with the band.
Yep. Like, you know, and like they couldn't even remember who the band. It wasn't like some fucking, like just, you only get once in a lifetime to hang out with these guys. Nah, it's just some fucking band in Texas.
Yep.
I mean, like, I'm going to stay with the band. Like,
it's funny.
Hey, you got a wife and kids. Fuck Mother's Day tomorrow, Dan, but okay.
Stay with the band.
Chew some kneecaps in here.
All right.
That's still the greatest press conference of all time.
Oh, my God, yeah.
2 hours in, the fucking PR guy is like, all right, we only got time for 6 or 7 more questions. Like, fuck, everybody's asked 9 questions. Yeah. Can we get this guy
out of here?
Yeah.
You know what, that one, I love his press conferences, and I love the new Eagles coach's press conferences.
Because he doesn't know what he's saying?
He doesn't know anything he fucking says come out of his mouth.
The fact that he referenced about Kobayashi.
Yeah.
Of like, hey, you realize like that's the second best guy in the sport, right?
Yeah, it's not
like
not
your
the
whole
best.
Reference of like most of these guys since they've been alive. This guy hasn't fucking won.
Yeah, no shit. Yeah, it's
well, he wants his water to be at this team. That's why he's so great. It's like, well, he's not the best though.
Nope, he's not
the second best.
Yep.
Yeah.
All righty. NFC East. This is a toughie.
Football team.
Okay.
I just don't. Fuck Cowboys. I don't buy them. I, you know, I don't know.
Yeah, no, I'm going the football team too.
Yeah.
Obviously,
I think they actually got better.
They did get better.
They have Fitzmagic, man. Everybody fucking loves him. But, you know, they pick up, well, they picked up Curtis Samuel. They pick, I mean, they got better.
That defense is solid as shit and they're all young. I mean, that's, they drafted the one linebacker out of, what was it, Kentucky that they got? I think to play the, I mean, that's, he was a number. I think that was their number one pick. Yeah,
yeah. When you had him, of I think they've. He's not quite like Zimmer is, but he was fucking close. Of like, get vaccinated. God damn it!
Yeah,
I had cancer.
Yeah,
I mean, it was like,
just do it. Just do it. I mean, I like you said, they won it last year.
Yeah,
with backup quarterbacks.
And I don't know that anybody repeats in that division.
No, but I mean. They're the best team so far. I mean, I don't think Dallas figures anything out. I still think they're going to fuck up.
At the end of the day, they almost beat the Super Bowl champions in the fucking playoffs with a guy that nobody knew.
Nobody knows. All righty. NFC South. Both going with the Bucks.
Yeah, I think there's a pretty good chance they might win that division.
Yeah, I agree with that. And probably the only reason I don't pick the Saints is just because it's a new quarterback.
Yeah.
No matter which way you go. If Drew Brees was still there and he wasn't, you know, had that noodle for an arm, I'd probably pick the Saints. But
kind of getting out on the Drew Brees. I used to like Drew Brees a lot, but then it was like the way he kind of drug it out, kind of gotten that Brett Favre thing of like, hey, man,
just retire.
Just fucking call it quits.
Yeah. All right. Here's another toughie. The West, the NFC West.
I'm just going to go with the Rams just because of what they've done. And I like Matt Stafford.
Cool. Cool. I am going to go with, I'm probably going to go with the Niners. I don't believe Jimmy G starts the season.
Really? I think he does.
Sorry, let me say that. He starts the first game and then maybe the first 3 games. And then I think they go to Trey Lance. I really do. I think that he makes the offense that much better. And I think Jimmy G just is going to lose a step because of all of his injuries.
The way I see it is Trey Lance is better, but he's still a bit of a project.
Yeah.
But you have a Super Bowl ready team and a quarterback that got you there.
Yeah. Yeah, exactly.
I agree with you. I think Trey Lance is going to play this year, but I think it's going to be because Jimmy G gets fucking injured somewhere.
Yeah. No,
I think that's what it.
But I think they're still, you know, on paper, they're still probably the best team.
Yeah.
And they just got to go out and do it.
Oh, that was you texting
me. That was
me.
I just sent the picks over there. Yeah, I mean, I just look at the defense still. I mean, the defense is still really, really good. I don't think they're going to lose a step losing Saleh. I mean, yeah, he can put you in the positions that you're going to be in, but it's still an NFL defense.
Yeah.
Everybody, and you're just going to go make the plays, you know? And then offensively, Shanahan hasn't lost a step. I just want to see him kind of take that next step and win one.
Yeah.
You know,
and
what I mean?
Think everybody forgets that half their team was injured last year.
Yeah. And they still won seven games or so. Yeah. Less than that, because they had like the number two or three pick.
They traded for that.
Yeah.
They had like the 12.
Mm-hmm. But I just, it's hard for me to sell. It's hard for me to go with the Seahawks because I think they're just they're so up and down. You don't know, are they going to run the ball like they should, or are they going to let Russ, you know, somewhat cook?
Russ is going to cook for the first eight games and be amazing and then be so fucking worn out by the end of the year that he can't throw, but he wants to be a top five quarterback all the time. So we got to let me do what I want to do because I'm more important than the team because I'm bag shit.
Did you get that out? Good?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. So we haven't had an episode in a while where we didn't shit on Russell Wilson. And then, like we talked about earlier, I just don't think the Cardinals are there. I don't think Kyler Murray, you're not winning the division until the Niners have to start paying their people.
Yeah.
And when the Rams have to start paying their guys.
Yeah. It's just the Kyler Murray thing. It's just the up and down shit.
Mm-hmm.
300 yards, 100 yards.
Yep.
I mean,
yeah. And no interceptions, two.
Yeah.
You know, yeah. It's got to be consistent. And you have too much, you have too many weapons to not have consistency.
Yeah.
I mean, the receiving core is just dumb. Just dumb. Yeah. Christian
it's
Kirk.
Fucking college receiving core.
Yeah.
I mean,
DeAndre
really
Hopkins, Christian Kirk, AJ Green. Fuck. I mean, if Fitzgerald wants to come back at some point in time in the season, they're not going to not give him that minimum. There's four receivers right there.
Yeah.
Yeah. Wild. Wild.
Wild stuff.
You get J.J. Watt.
More than the guy that's better than him.
Yeah, exactly. Chandler Jones is not
What are they doing
traded.
There?
They got to give him whatever the fuck he wants.
Because he's Chandler fucking Jones.
Exactly.
You paid this guy fucking $16 million, and he's not half the player he used to be.
Nope.
And the guy on the other side's way fucking better.
He has the same numbers that J.J. Watt has in the same time span that they do the numbers.
Yeah. It's just J.J. Watt, you know. J.J. Watt didn't get traded to Arizona in the best years of his career.
Yeah.
You know, he was Chandler, I mean, he was in New England. You're never the guy there. And then you get traded to a place where people forget they had a team.
Mm-hmm.
And J.J. Watt was the face of a fucking franchise because he didn't have anything else there. Because when they were actually winning playoff games, you couldn't name their fucking quarterback.
Yeah.
Because the two playoff games they won was against the Bengals. Uh-huh. So it doesn't count.
Tom Savage was one of them.
Yeah.
Tom Savage was one of them. And then the other one, who was the other one?
Because that was a year, too, that they had a home game and they played the Bengals. And the only reason, the Bengals had like 11 wins, but the Steelers had fucking 12. It was something like that.
Where they had to.
It was the Texans were like 500, but.
Yeah, they won the division. So. Yep. Yeah. Which is, if you go back to Tebow time in Denver, it was the same situation with the Steelers. They had the better record, but they didn't win their division, so they had to go to Denver.
Yeah.
Ryan Clark can't play in the high altitude because of his sickle cell disease.
Right.
So he probably makes that play on Demaryius Thomas.
Yeah, Tim Tebow doesn't make an 80-yard touchdown pass, but everybody shits on him, but won a playoff game.
And speaking of that, it's going to bring me up on a rant. As good as the NFL is with a lot of shit, how come overtime still is a bag of dicks?
Yeah, I don't know. I don't know what you do because college overtime is not the fucking answer.
It's not.
Because you don't even play football there.
Yeah, it's not, but it's everybody should at least get a try.
Yeah.
The idea of, because you look at this whole sudden death thing, which is what they want.
Yeah.
But they're like, well, we got to give the other team a chance because you're literally leaving it up to a coin flip.
I am okay, and it doesn't have to be 15 minutes.
No.
Hey, let's just play a 10-minute quarter. And if nobody scores there, if you want to call it a tie there, I'm fine. I don't care.
Mm-hmm.
But if nobody scores in that 10 minutes and then you want to go to 2-point conversion things for a sudden death, okay.
I just don't like how there's a tie in the NFL.
Yeah.
Now, this year, with the 17th game, it may not mean a whole hell of a lot because you still have enough, you know what I mean? So that might change some things with a tie. But these guys are NFL players. Yeah. This is the best of the best, and we still have ties.
Yeah.
You know, I think you should have your kickoff and everything. I still think both teams should get a shot at it. And then if it's still tied by both teams gets a shot out of it, we go in from the 30 or the 40.
Well, I'm all for.
And you have to go
for
two.
Let's continue to play football.
Mm-hmm.
So let's have a timed quarter.
Okay.
And if it's 8 minutes, that's fine too.
Yeah.
and then we can go. I'm a big proponent of the if you're doing a shootout, mm-hmm. let's just do the 2-point conversion
yeah.
shootout.
Yeah,
let's fuck get it over.
Give them both. Yeah, put the 15 on there.
But let's play regular football.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Yeah, not put it at
you
the
like in college of like yeah 20. I don't want ties in college either. Yeah. But you don't even play football in there mm-hmm. of like, or if you're gonna do it that way, back it up a little bit that you yeah. you're not in field goal range uh-huh. already.
Yeah,
I mean like you need to earn something.
Yeah, yeah, that's I don't mind the time thing, but we just can't end it a tie. The 2-point conversion thing: if you score a touchdown, you have to go for two, unless the touchdown doesn't mean anything. If the other team kicks a field goal and you go down and score a touchdown, you don't have to fucking go for right. two. You already won, but. Yeah, it's just, yeah, I mean,
it's fucked up.
Mm-hmm. It's got to change.
Well, we got to protect these guys. They're playing a lot of ball. Well, you keep adding games. So,
yeah, so
you add another playoff game and then you add another fucking regular season game. What yeah. are we talking about, boys?
Yeah.
We need you to be protected for all this stuff. You've got to get all your testing done and everything. Can't see your family. Can't do anything this, but you can have a joint practice when we bring 100 other fucking yeah. guys in here from another city.
That makes
what
sense.
What are we fucking doing, guys?
It doesn't make any sense. But that's the NFL.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, while we're doing picks, you want to do some college stuff?
Yeah.
You just want to pick the playoff, I guess?
I guess. You just want to name the top
I mean,
three?
I don't even... Yeah. yeah. I mean, I don't... Yeah. There's nothing else you can pick.
No.
Well, give me
you
your
go
four.
By, we can go, you want to go are four you, or you want to go actually number them? To make it a little difficult. Or difficult. Okay. Go one.
Yeah, that works.
Okay. All right, so I believe my number one is still going to be Alabama.
Yeah.
I think that's kind of...
given.
Yeah. My number one is going to be Bama. My number two is going to be Ohio State. I think that they can... I think, again...
Right.
I think they're the best, second best. I think Clemson kind of takes a step back. I don't know if that Hugga Maga Louie... I don't know how you say his name. Yeah. You know, the quarterback.
Yep.
You know, he's not Trevor Lawrence.
No.
And their defense is kind of starting to take a step back. They're not getting those same recruits that they were. So I think that they take a step back. I think Oklahoma is three this year.
Yeah.
I think they're three. And then I think that Clemson is four.
Okay. I'm going to go Bama.
Okay.
Oklahoma's going to be at 2.
Okay.
Ohio State will be at 3. Mainly because I think both of them just go undefeated, and it doesn't really fucking matter.
Okay.
But they're ahead of them already.
Yeah.
And, you know, Ohio State's only game that they really technically have is Oregon. Mm-hmm. And then by the end of the year, you're going to realize that Oregon wasn't any good.
Mm-hmm.
And number 4, Georgia.
Georgia.
I think Georgia's only loss is to Alabama.
Okay. No, I like that one.
Because I think they get Clemson.
Yeah. Yeah, they play each other, right?
First game of the year.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. I like that. I do. I think I just haven't seen, we haven't seen Georgia win a big game yet.
No.
They beat, if you want to call that win against Cincinnati a big win, but you look at the last 2 years, they go to the college football championship game.
Yeah.
Get beat by Alabama on the last second. They should have won that fucking game.
100%
should have won that game. Because it was a fluke. I mean, Bama had to switch fucking quarterbacks halfway through. That's me again. Had to switch quarterbacks halfway through the fucking game because Jalen Hurts was sucking.
Yeah.
So you should have won that game. Then the next year is your bowl game with Texas. You should have fucking just wiped the fucking floor with Texas. But you don't.
No.
You can beat by Texas. You should have wiped the fucking floor with Cincinnati last year.
But then again, should have got beat by them.
Yes, exactly. And so I that's really the only thing. It doesn't seem like it doesn't seem like they make adjustments and the other team does.
Yeah. My only thing is I think they will beat Clemson.
Mm-hmm.
Now I'll probably be, you know, I'll lose my, yeah. I'll lose it fucking week one. The only way, like if they beat Clemson, the only way they don't make it is for somehow if they'd get beat by like fucking Florida or something like that. But if you're yeah. if you're that level and you're Georgia thinking this is where you belong, mm-hmm. you can't.
Yeah.
You don't lose.
No.
The only teams that beat you are Clemson, Ohio State, and Alabama. That's yeah. the only teams you can lose mm-hmm. to if you want to be at that level.
Yeah.
So if they beat Clemson, the only way they don't get in is if they get the SEC championship game and get mm-hmm. beat by 40
yeah.
by Alabama.
Yeah.
Which is possible.
Good. Yeah, very well. Because
then they can just say, mm-hmm. well, we're going to go with,
yeah,
we're going to bring Clemson back yep. in. Or, you know. Yep.
Yeah.
So now with that, I don't know what the fuck they're talking about with that announcement of the alliance between fucking... What are you doing?
I don't know.
I don't even know what it... I was scheduling stuff. Oh, you mean like normal?
Yeah.
Because what are you doing?
I don't know why that's even a thing.
Are you going to schedule games against each other like you do already?
You should. Like, you're not... Like, you just... Are you guys pissed off because the SEC just took two good teams and made their conference that much better?
Yeah.
That's what you're pissed off.
That's what you're pissed off.
Yeah. So you're going to come up with this, we're going to go against the big SEC and, you know, get pissy because they took our two good teams.
Yeah.
Fucking do the same thing.
If the Big Ten was anything, they would look right down and go, hey, Clemson, you want to...
Yeah. Oh, shit.
I know you run your conference and you think ACC is fucking life.
Yep.
But you're not the Big Ten.
No.
And I know the Big Ten's not a strong conference.
They're better than the ACC as a whole.
But they carry fucking money better than everybody else except the SEC.
Yeah.
Actually, I think they might... They're pretty close with the SEC as far as money, football contracts are concerned. Of just like...
Hey, come on over.
Notre Dame, Clemson.
Let's go.
Get the fuck in.
Yep.
Let's go.
Yeah. Could be in babies
fuck
about
the rest
it.
Of you.
Yeah. Nobody... Why the fuck are we having an alliance with...
Well, they're making that alliance so they all vote the same fucking way so they can stop the expansion of the playoff because they don't want the SEC to have so many
which
teams.
Which is just so fucking stupid.
It's just fucking stupid.
It's not... The expansion is not meant for the SEC to have all their fucking teams in. The expansion is meant for the Cincinnati's and the North Carolina's and the BYU's who have a good season for those guys to get in. It's not meant... If the SEC gets in those guys, they fucking get in those guys because they're just the better teams that are in there.
Well, that's the other thing is, well, they can't, if they have six of them, that's not fair. Well, be better.
Yeah.
Because I'll tell you, of the two teams they're bringing in, Texas wouldn't have made it if it was in the fucking top 12.
No.
So
not even a little bit. So, yeah, I mean, if you're the Big Ten, if you're even the Big Ten, I'm bringing in three.
Yeah.
I'm bringing in Notre Dame, trying to get them in, trying to get Clemson in. We already go ahead and play in Iowa. Iowa State, just come on, come over here and we'll do this.
Yeah.
I
don't understand what this alliance is supposed to fucking accomplish. So you want Ohio State and USC to play each other? Okay.
Okay, yeah.
They just did that not too long ago.
And they beat the piss out of them, and USC hasn't gotten any fucking better since.
No. So you act like, well, we want this alliance so the Rose Bowl would matter. Nobody fucking cares about your fucking bowl games anymore.
Nobody cares. If it's not the college football playoffs, nobody gives a shit.
You have a national championship game, that's all that matters.
Yeah.
The only people that care about the Motor City Bowl are the parents of the kids playing.
Yes, exactly.
And they're pissed off that they got to go to Detroit. Granted, most of those teams come from Northern Ohio and Michigan anyways.
Yeah, so it does.
Because it's mostly a MAC thing.
Yeah.
But sometimes they have to come from fucking Illinois. So.
Yeah, exactly. I just don't get it. It honestly reminded me of, like, just people ganging up, like, getting pissed off because somebody's, like, bigger and better than them. That's what it reminds
me
of.
That's all it is.
You got that one fucking really, really good team, and you got all these other small teams. Like, we got to vote against everything that they do just to spite them. Fuck you guys.
That's one of those things of, like, be better.
Yeah.
You beat them.
Beat them.
Because since we've had an actual national champion, I think the SEC's won half of them.
Yeah. Yeah.
Since, you know, since it started with the BCS.
Mm-hmm.
So BCS to current, I want to say the SEC's won, like, half of the national championships.
Yeah.
So.
Yeah.
They should be represented more in the playoff.
Yeah,
they should be. It's actually a detriment to them because you only have four teams.
Exactly.
And let's be real fucking honest. If the Big Ten would pick up Clemson and Notre Dame, then they'd start talking with the SEC and say, we don't need the rest of these motherfuckers.
Exactly. Let's just go ahead and do
this. Here's our commissioner. We're going to do our shit.
Yep.
Bye-bye.
Mm-hmm.
Which what's going to happen anyways.
It needs to happen. It needs to happen.
We're doing things for fucking bowl games about for teams that are... Well, the bowl games, we got to protect them. Oh, from letting 6-6 teams in, and you can't fill the spots, so you got to let a fucking 5-7 team in.
Exactly. Stupid.
Stupid fuckers. Why are they not coming to us for the answers?
Because they don't want to hear it. They do not want to hear the truth.
We've given it 100 times already.
They can't handle the truth.
Sons of bitches. That's still one of my favorite prank phone calls of all time. I'm sure you know what you want to talk about. They play that all...
Yeah.
You can't handle the truth.
You can't handle
what?
The truth. What?
The fact that lady stayed on the phone for that long and was still great.
You need me on that wall.
There's something about back in the day that's off in a tangent side. I think we've covered college football enough. It's there's five teams at best in the whole fucking thing.
Pretty
Let's
much.
Just go ahead and make sure they can have a playoff.
Mm-hmm.
But I miss prank phone calls because that was always so funny. Fucking funny.
Yeah.
And like you can't really do it anymore because if I don't recognize the number, I'm not picking it up.
Exactly. When I first got a cell phone, I think I was like in the sixth grade and it only had calling because it was only for like to be picked up after a practice if school was, you know, out earlier. You know, it was for emergencies only. Yeah. Well, of course, I don't know if I even had it for majority of the time because it always got taken away because I would always prank call people.
Yeah.
And, you know, you only really prank call people at that point in time that you had the fucking number for.
Right.
And they know what you sound like. So when you prank call them, I mean, I used to get calls and like after get home and like, hey, did you call this person today? No, I don't know what you're talking about. Give me your phone. Fuck. I forgot about
There's
that.
A call There's log. A call log. Shit.
Yeah, you lost it. Damn.
Well,
it.
I remember when I first got a cell phone, but then you'd just like leave and mm-hmm. like I might not even carry it for a week and just be at the house.
Yeah.
Like, and then I remember at that point too, because I remember where I was when the switch happened of when you had to start dialing an area code. Because you used to not have to. If you were in our area code, you just dial the fucking number.
Mm-hmm.
And I kept and I couldn't get through. I'm like, what the fuck? And then you had to start dialing an area code. I'm like, God damn.
This is weird. And then sometimes you had to put the one in front of it and sometimes you didn't have to, just depending on how close you were. And
I'm still pretty happy because like with my phone, like my phone number is still like an old school cell phone number. It's not one of the new, not one of the new area codes, not one of the new numbers where it's like, ew.
Yeah.
You know? It's like, I still have a prideful number.
Yeah. I know what you mean.
All right, man. I'm really hot.
Yeah, me too.
I'd like to get some air conditioning.
Yeah.
All right.
Whiteside.